bankruptcy, NYCDEP, is willing to take ownership. And whereas in order for these buyouts to continue being processed, the town and NYCDEP must enter into an agreement regarding maintenance of said parcels, whereby NYCDEP is offering minimal maintenance, including annual property inspections, boundary maintenance, and signage, but not including active management, mowing, snow plowing, etc. And whereas the town understands that moving forward, if the town wishes active management activities to take place on these parcels, the town would have to take responsibility for these through a permitting process of the NYCDEP. Therefore, be it resolved that the town of Shandaken Town Board does hereby authorize the town supervisor to enter into an agreement with NYCDEP with understanding of all that is prescribed above, and moves the following parcels forward through the FEMA buyout program. Parcel number 8595, section block lot number 25.15-1-48, owner T. Byron. Parcel number 8601, SBL number 12.18-2-7, owner J. Blydenberg. Parcel number 8603, SBL number 25.1-2-20, owner J. Barden, and move its adoption.
I'll second that.
Board Member Malloy?
Yes.
Board Member Storms?
Yes.
Supervisor Snell?
Yes.
Resolution 112-15, advertising for bids for installation of 3 town information kiosks funded by Smart Growth Grant. Whereas the town of Shandaken has been awarded a Smart Growth Grant from New York State DEC, which has included the installation of 4 town-oriented information kiosks, and whereas the town has been successful in the installation of 1 kiosk using volunteers at the Big Indian Park, and whereas the town on several occasions has made its best effort in its request for volunteers for the installation of the final 3 kiosks, Main Street Phoenicia, Ash Road and Route 42, Shandaken, Main Street Pine Hill, with minimal response from the public, and whereas the town has had enough remaining funds in the Smart Growth Grant available for the necessary materials and labor to install these kiosks, including the installation of bluestone bases and solar lighting fixtures for all 4 kiosks, and whereas the town has contacted DEC and received approval for this activity. Therefore, be resolved that the Town of Shandaken Town Board hereby advertise for bids to install the 3 kiosks and install bluestone bases and solar lighting fixtures on all 4 kiosks, and that any interested individuals or corporations who wish to bid on this project must attend a mandatory site visit at Big Indian Park to inspect the constructed kiosks on Thursday, September 24, 2015 at 11 a.m. Be it further resolved that any bid be submitted along with any other requirements as prescribed in the attached request for proposal, RFP, to the Town of Shandaken Town Clerk's Office located at 7209 Route 28, P.O. Box 67, Shandaken, New York, 12480, no later than 3 p.m. on Monday, October 5th, 2015, and must be in a sealed envelope clearly marked on the exterior of the envelope in large block letters, Kiosk Bid, which said bids to be opened and read aloud at the regularly scheduled town board meeting that evening at 7 p.m. I move its adoption.
Second.
Board Member Malloy?
Yes.
Board Member Storms?
Yes.
Supervisor Snell?
Yes.
So what's next? You want this?
Oh, no, that's the RFP. Yeah, that goes with the other resolution.
Okay.
Resolution 113-15, advertising for bids for repair of Morton Library Portico. Whereas the Morton Memorial Library Building, Morton Library, located on Elm Street in Pine Hill, is owned by the town of Shandaken. And whereas the Morton Library is a historic structure listed on both the state and national registry. And whereas the building serves a substantial portion of the community and provides open access to library materials, provides educational opportunities, social gathering, and computer access to a significant portion of the public, including residents and visitors. And whereas the portico at the entrance of the Morton Library is in need of necessary repair in order to continue operating and to provide these assets to the community at large. And whereas the town has good neighbor funds available to assist in this repair. Therefore, it be resolved that the Town of Shandaken Town Board hereby advertise for bids to repair the portico at the Morton Library, and that any interested individuals or corporations who wish to bid on this repair may schedule an appointment to inspect the portico or may inspect on their own, and that any bid for the repair be submitted along with a minimum of 3 references to the town of Shandaken, town clerk's office located at 7209 Route 28, P.O. Box 67, Shandaken, New York, 12480. No later than 3 p.m. on Monday, October 5th, 2015. It must be in a sealed envelope, clearly marked on the exterior of the envelope, in large block letters, library bid, and send bids to open and read aloud at the regularly scheduled town board meeting that evening at 7 p.m. And be it further resolved that the town's good neighbor funds must be used to pay for the repair based on the bids received that evening. And I move its adoption.
I'll second.
Board Member Malloy?
Yes.
Board Member Storr?
Yes.
Supervisor Snell?
Yes. Resolution 11415, accept part-time police resignation. Whereas John Vanden Doorn has submitted a resignation letter to the town of Shandaken for his position with the town of Shandaken Police Department. Therefore, be it resolved, the town board of Shandaken hereby accepts John Vanden Doorn's resignation from the town of Shandaken Police Department and move its adoption.
I'll second that.
Board Member Malloy?
Yes.
Board Member Storr?
Yes.
Supervisor Snell?
Yes.
Okay. Resolution 115-15, resolution hiring town police part-time officer. Whereas pursuant to section 20 of the town law, the town board should designate all appointed officers and employees of the town. Therefore, be it resolved that Ryan V. Benicasa be and hereby is appointed part-time police officer for the town of Shandaken Police Department, starting September 14, 2015. And receive a part-time rate of $19.17 per hour while discharging the duties of said office. I move its adoption.
Second that.
Board Member Malloy?
Yes.
Board Member Storms?
Yes.
Supervisor?
Yes.
Resolution 116-15, resolution hiring ambulance part-time technicians. Whereas, pursuant to Section 20 of the town law, the town board should designate all appointed officers and employees of the town. Therefore, it be resolved that James Coddington be and hereby is appointed part-time ambulance technician for the town of Shandaken Ambulance Department to be paid $197.68 per 12-hour shift, including trips. And I move its adoption.
Second.
Board Member Malloy?
Yes.
Board Member Storm?
Yes.
Supervisor Snell?
Yes.
I almost said including tips.
Oh. Awesome. That'd be awesome.
Resolution 117-50. Resolution requesting no campaign signage until after Columbus Day, October 12, 2015. Whereas the town of Shandaken recognizes the importance of preserving its natural beauty and viewscapes throughout the town. And whereas Columbus Day weekend is recognized as a highly desirable time for visitors to travel to our area and enjoy the pristine beauty of Shandaken. Therefore, the town board of Shandaken requests that campaign signs for the general election, regardless of party affiliation or contest, not be displayed until after Columbus Day, October 12, 2015, and move its adoption.
One second.
Board Member Malloy?
Yes.
Board Member Storm?
Yes.
Supervisor Snell?
Yes.
Open public comment.
There's no public comment.
Yes.
On the people that passed away at the end of the meeting.
Yes.
Jeannie Gormley lost his sister this month.
I was wrong.
Ann Smith.
Wrong point.
I didn't know she wasn't wrong.
Yeah.
I didn't know she passed.
Yeah.
I will add. We will move to adjourn the meeting in memory of Georgia Nay, Jordan Engler, and Ann Smith.
We're 6 weeks
from yesterday.
That's right.
That's right.
Because of Labor Day.
Big Indian.
Big Indian.
Oliver Reef.
Yeah, Oliver.
It's just before the Cold Spring launch. Nice thing is the Jets aren't playing on Sunday, so I can play.
So did you end up staying the whole thing?
Yeah, I did. I just